Welcome back to another financial tidbit, folks. It's your favorite financial know-it-all, Brad. Here to make sense of your money matters. Today, we're diving into the thrilling world of IRAs. Not the Irish Republic Army, folks. We're talking about individual retirement accounts. More specifically, we're talking about the potential pitfalls of moving or inheriting them. Now, let's set the scene. Aunt Edna, that lovable but eccentric relative, has left you her IRA in her will. Congratulations! You're now wealthier! And all you had to do was listen to her cat stories at every family gathering. Now you might think, I'll just move that IRA over to my account. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Well, not so fast, my financially aspiring friend. You see, IRAs aren't as simple to move as, let's say, your grandma's antique rocking chair. Whew! Even the thought of moving that chair is exhausting. Now back to IRAs. If you're a non-spouse inheritor, you can't just roll into your own IRA. Nope, it becomes an inherited IRA. And you thought the IRS terminology was going to be easy. Now, with this inherited IRA, you've got rules. We're not talking house rules like no elbows on the table or don't feed the dog under the dinner table. These are IRS rules, and they mean business. You can't contribute to it. Also, you have to take required minimum distributions regardless of your age. And don't forget, you'll have to pay taxes on those distributions. Now, what about moving your own IRA, you ask? That's got to be simpler, right? Maybe not. If you withdraw funds and you don't get them into another IRA within 60 days, guess what? Boom! Taxable distribution. Plus, you might even get a 10% early withdrawal penalty if you're under 59 and a half years old. It's like being late to your own surprise party and getting fined for it. Now, to avoid this, you can execute what they call a trustee-to-trustee transfer. It's like passing a hot potato straight from one person to the next without dropping it. And trust me, you don't want to drop this hot potato. Whew! Now that was hot. So with a trustee-to-trustee transfer, your IRA goes directly from one institution to another without risking the 60-day rule. Because let's face it, time flies when you're, well, doing anything other than keeping track of your IRA transfer days. So what's the moral of the story, folks? When dealing with IRAs, don't try to wing it. Even financial angels need help sometimes. If you're inheriting an IRA, understand the rules. Know what you're getting into. Or you might end up turning that financial blessing into a tax headache. And if you're moving your IRA, consider a trustee-to-trustee transfer, unless, of course, you enjoy playing with financial hot potatoes. That's all for now, folks. If you found this information useful and got a chuckle or two, smash that like button and don't forget to subscribe for more financial fun. This is Brad, signing off.